focuses on cutting-edge domain knowledge and benchmarking with world-class businesses.
Big Tech.
Really done a
path-breaking
work. And most of you, or in fact, I would say each one of you in your own domain have achieved a great deal. And therefore, just for having been given the responsibility of the Defence Ministry by the Honourable Prime Minister, I seem to be sharing these times with you. However, I think it is possible in India, however difficult the path may be, to steadily push ahead. And it is on that score I would want to broadly exchange my views and my experiences with you. In a way, my entry also into politics was fairly late. Unlike many who have spent from their college days steadily, I've been in a bit of politics when I was in university, then I went off, and then I came back, and so on. So the reason why I want to mention that up front is it's not necessary in today's India for us to be in the same chosen path. There is opportunity even if you want to move laterally. So, and the lateral entry has its own benefit. Benefit for the individual and also benefit for the domain into which you enter or get out of. Because that kind of a cross-pollination enriches your and also the place where you go to, the experiences that can be had, both by the individual and also by the institutions. But today, for a minute, if I just focus on women and their role, I wanted to, when I came in, I thought I'd be talking about what defense industry can benefit with more women in it. But before I do that, I want to really thank the FLO for doing such a study. I do not know whether this is the first time you've done it or you've been doing it over the years, on women's work participation. I think this is one thing which you have to steadily keep monitoring, collecting data on, and looking at various sectors in which the flow is more or the flow is lesser, the coming in and going out of women from the work. But I'm not sure again whether you're looking at only the formal sector employment when you've done this study. And if that is so, we are missing out on a large number of women who are in the informal sector. And I say this with great sense of responsibility because when this government brought in the Mudra loan, which is giving anyone who is absolutely or largely in the lower rung of society, who would be in no position to provide security or assets for guarantee, still needed credit, and for them the financial inclusion idea of this government wanted to extend them the benefit of getting credit for their little economic activity without having to depend on property or jewelry or anything with the consent of the family, which becomes a given. You really are not going to be able to break that out for them to come and secure their loans with that kind of security. So the government's interest, and particularly the Prime Minister's interest, was to reach out to all those who needed, male, female to start with, who needed that kind of an assistance, and therefore the Mudra loan was brought on. But after a year or possibly even 1.5 years, the data shows that more than 50% of those who benefited from Mudra are women, which means the workforce participation of women in the informal sector is significant, and we don't capture them most often because any study, when you're going through formal assumptions and randomization of data, is easy to operate and justifiably easy to operate when you look at only formal sectors. When you have to cover data from the informal sector, it becomes a rather more cumbersome research methodology that you have to adopt, and as a result, probably, I don't want to conclude, but probably as a result, we don't easily get the data from the informal sector. But I would think today, in the larger context of the job creation debate which is ongoing in India today, the data on the formal sector does not adequately capture the data of total employment in the country, of which the larger chunk is of the informal, both of male and female. And going by the Mudra data which is available for me, with 50% of women benefiting from it, we are missing out on a lot. We are missing out on a lot, particularly that segment which has lots more women in it. So I think it might be important that that is also captured. It might be interesting for Flo to take up that aspect of informal sector, women's
business.
Thank you, sir.